What has Zionism got to do with it? When I made a recent video, I called it Zionism is Good. This was a mistake. The first title I had in mind was Jews Go Home, a much better idea. Many people on the right seem to have a problem with Jews and Zionism, a problem of definition. Zion is the name of the hill upon which Jerusalem is built. To be a Zionist is to want there to be a homeland for Jews in and around Jerusalem. That is what it means, and that is all that it means. Not every nefarious plan concocted by Jews, either real or imaginary, is Zionist. Zionist is not a synonym for conspiring Jew. You don't need to be Jewish to be a Zionist, and you are not a Zionist just because you are Jewish. 100 years ago, there were conspiring Zionist Jews who used dubious and ungentlemanly means to get a commitment from the Entente powers to create a homeland for Jews in Palestine. This commitment led to the bringing in of America into the First World War. When Hollywood portrays the First World War, we see images of the sinking of the Lusitania, followed by heroic doughboys crossing the Atlantic, and this fades into victory parades in Paris. The reality is that the Lusitania was sunk in May 1915, and it wasn't until April 1917 that America declared war on Germany. While the British Empire and France were fighting the Germans on the Somme in 1916, the only war America was involved in was invading Haiti. But during this time, the British and French were dividing up the spoils of the collapsing Ottoman Empire, and it became clear that there was a never-to-be-repeated opportunity to secure a Jewish homeland. Jewish interests across the globe became focused on this primary objective. If Jewish interests could swing the Americans in behind the Entente powers and bring the war to an end, in return, the British government would pledge to set up a Jewish homeland. This was the high tide of Zionism. While America had entered into the war before the Balfour Declaration was made, the mobilizing of Jewish interests across the world behind the Entente and their new American allies was an important part of what helped tip the balance and end the atrocious bloody stalemate in what some people call the Great European Civil War. So here we have rich internationalist Jews conspiring against the interests of the German and Austrian people in the name of Zionism. This is a major plank in the German resentment which went on to cause the tragedy of the Nazi regime and their genocide against European Jews. Zionists are real. They are rich, powerful, influential, and they are Jewish. But that doesn't mean that all movements with rich, influential Jews involved with them are Zionist. Israel exists now. The Zionist goal has been realized. There are many Jews involved with political causes today, but these are not Zionists. They are internationalist Jews who want to secure the other half of the Jewish good life, the opening up of all the best parts of the world for the safety and free movement of Jews. That is nothing to do with Zionism. It is basic human nature to want good things for yourself, and to put that as a higher priority than good things for other people. Those men with the power to do so ensure that they have a beautiful and chaste wife, or many wives secure in harems, while they are free to philander with other women. It is what you do if you can. It has always been the way of the world. It is hardly surprising that Jews also want the equivalent, a safe place for Jews, kept safe from their enemies, and at the same time, access for Jews to travel wherever they want to travel or set up home. An example of this double standards can be seen in the life of Vidal Sassoon. He is most famous as a celebrity hairdresser, itself a rather strange concept. Sassoon was no lightweight, limp-wristed, effeminate homosexual. He was a street fighter. In the immediate post-war East End of London, an area now no doubt inhabited by Bangladeshis, he was a Jewish anti-fascist street fighter who attacked members of the British League of Ex-Servicemen and Women and later Sir Oswald Mosley's Union Movement. The left are in raptures about this man, a Jew who fought alongside other Jews for the right of Jews and against British nationalist forces who wanted to have a Britain prioritising the needs and interests of the British natives. In 1948, this street fighter, who was just about to turn 20, took himself off to Palestine to fight against other British young men and against the native population in that land in the 1948 Arab-Israeli War. Again, he was fighting alongside Jews for the interests of Jews, but this time he wasn't fighting against nationalists, he was a nationalist. Jewish nationalism good, British nationalism bad. That's the twin-track approach of Jews. It is only Zionist when it is connected with Israel. When it is about shaping lands where they are a minority, so they can be more comfortable there, this is not Zionism at all. It is Jewish internationalism. Please stop calling people Zionists just because they are Jews with an agenda. Not every Jew with an agenda is concerned with the state of Israel. When they are concerned with Israel, they are quite easy to cope with. We can easily understand their motives: survival, security, and prosperity in Israel. That is a perfectly noble cause. All people are entitled to their own homeland. But we do have a problem with Jews who want to undermine our nationalist aspirations. When Jews want to make all other forms of nationalism illegitimate and evil, we have every right to object and to call them out on it, and to explore their hypocrisy. But not all Jewish internationalists are Zionists. They are not all hypocrites in the Sassoon mold. Some are truly internationalist, pure and simple. It is not their being Zionists which is the problem, unless you're a Palestinian. It is their obsession with derailing nationalism when people other than the Jews are the nation in question.